As we have gone through requirements, let us go through data modeling using MongoDB and also set up database. In our case, we have an application which is already pointing to MySQL. Now we want to change from MySQL to MongoDB. So when it comes to data modeling using MongoDB, it is typically different from traditional RDBMS. Often we might have to use collections with nested documents. In our case, we will merge orders and order items. If you actually look at the current data model, it is like this. We have 6 tables. All of them are related. We have relationship of one to many between orders and order items, because for a given order there can be multiple order items. There is one to many relationship between customers and orders. For every customer there can be n number of orders, and there is a one to many relationship between products and order items, because one product can be ordered multiple times. Out of these 6 tables, orders and order items are transactional tables. Others are kind of master data tables. So we will leave master data tables as is, and we will ignore categories and departments because there is no requirement around it. We need products, customers as is, and then orders and order items in a bit denormalized fashion. If you go to terminal and if you go to the directory where we have set up the dataset, in my case it is nothing but users IT versity research data retail DB. There are 2 retail DBs in this. One is normal retail DB, second one is retail DB JSON. So I'll be using retail DB JSON then retail DB, and then we have these 6 tables. We will ignore categories and departments. We will have customers, products, orders, and order items. We will load customers and products as is. When it comes to orders and order items, we will actually denormalize and have a denormalized collection. The reason why we want to denormalize is when we place the order, we need to add order items also. If they are separate in MongoDB, then committing all of them together is a bit complicated. If it is RDBMS, because we have primary key and foreign key relationships established, whenever we try to insert an order item without an order ID, it will throw an exception. And also, we can actually insert order first and then add order items, and we can commit all of them together. If something goes wrong in the middle, everything rolls back automatically for us. It's a feature which we'll get with the traditional RDBMS. But when it comes to NoSQL databases like MongoDB, the commit happens at each and every atomic operation, which means if we have an order ID which is inserted, and if there are corresponding order items with it, then once we insert order ID, it will be committed automatically with NoSQL databases like MongoDB. And then for each and every insert with respect to order items also, there will be a commit. So if something goes wrong in the middle, then only the last operation might get rolled back. Others will not. So handling transactions in MongoDB will get complicated if we have separate tables like this. Rather than having separate tables and rather than inserting as different records into orders and order items or perform different database operations into orders and order items, if we have a denormalized data model where we will consider the entire order as one document, we'll be able to insert that in one shot and we'll be able to commit. So if something goes wrong, nothing will be committed. If everything alright, one document will be inserted, and that one document will have all the details with respect to orders and also a nested list of documents with respect to order items. It will actually make our life easier when it comes to dealing with the transactions like that. Now, if you go to orders and if you look at the file, you can see that for each and every order, we have the data in JSON format. We have order ID, order date, order customer ID, order status. If you take order ID 2 and if you go to order items and then say view and then the JSON file name, for order ID 2, you can see that there are 3 records, 3 JSON objects. So we have to consolidate this data and have everything in orders so that we can build on that denormalized orders data model rather than normalized data model like this. If you want, we can have a normalized data model also in MongoDB, but we need to enforce the constraints at application level, and also if something goes wrong, we need to ensure that everything is cleaned up before going back to the original state. So instead of doing that, we'll be consolidating orders and order items into one collection where we will have one document for each and every order. And when it comes to order ID 2, we will have a 5th field by some name like order underscore items. And as part of that, we'll have a list of these documents and then we'll take it further. However, as our data sets are separate, we need to come up with logic to consolidate these things and then have the consolidated orders, and then we have to take it from there. So here, I'm going to Mongo. We already have this retail database, so I'm actually deleting that. It is db.dropdatabase, and then we have to give the database name, which is nothing but retail, and hit enter. Okay, so here I have to say use the retail, I have to switch to that database, and then I have to say db.dropDatabase. Then the database will be dropped. Now you say show DBs, and there is no retail database here. Now I can come out of this, and I can perform Mongo import as we have seen earlier. I will create a stage database to first load orders and order items so that we can consolidate and we can have one orders in retail. So it will look like this: Mongo import host localhost and then port 27017 db retail stage collection orders type JSON. There's no need to specify fields with JSON because as our data already have the field names, it will inherit from that itself. And then file, which is nothing but users ITversity research data retail underscore db underscore JSON, and then orders, and then the file name, and hit enter. You can see that 68,883 documents are inserted into retail underscore stage orders collection. Now we have to insert order items also. So host localhost port 27017 database retail stage collection order underscore items. It is order items like this. We can give whatever name we want. I am giving it like this. Type JSON and then file users ITversity research data retail DB JSON order items and then the file name and hit enter. As we have imported orders and order items into a stage database, now we'll actually consolidate into actual database called as retail under a collection by name orders. We'll come back to that after setting up products and customers. With respect to products and customers, there is no need to consolidate anything, and hence we'll actually import the data as is and we'll start using it as part of the application. So here I'm writing the Mongo import command to import products: host localhost port 27017 db retail collection products type JSON, file users ITversity research data retail db JSON products, and hit enter. It is a directory. I need to give the file name. The file name is nothing but this one, and hit enter. Now we have products also imported to our database retail. We have one more thing which we need to import, which is nothing but customers, and then the file name, which is nothing but this one. We have 12,435 documents with respect to customers collection. That being said, now we can launch Mongo and then say use retail, show collections. We can see customers and products here. We can preview the customers data by saying db.customers.find.pretty. You can see that for each and every customer, we have ID, first name, last name, email, password, street, city, state, zip code. We can also preview the products data. With respect to products, we have product ID, product category ID, product name, product description, product price, product image, etc. Now we need to create a new collection called as orders, and that collection should have consolidated data from retail stage orders and order items. For that, we have to write JavaScript code so that we can fetch the data and load into the new collection under retail. First, I am going to retail stage here, and then I am saying db.orderItems.findPretty to preview the data of order items. I would like to index on order item order ID because we have to look up into order items using this order item order ID. As we have already seen earlier also, if we index on order item order ID, it will be faster. So here I can say db.orderItems create index order item order ID, and we have to pass it as JSON like this, which will take care of creating the index for us. As part of MongoDB operations, we have understood the relationship between Mongo and JavaScript, and this is how we can actually develop the JavaScript to consolidate data from orders and order items. We have gone through this script earlier also. However, when we actually use this script earlier, we haven't removed any fields from order items. But if you look at the actual data by saying db.orderItems.find and then pretty, you see this collection have order item order ID as well. Order item order ID is same as the order ID in orders. When we are going to have a denormalized collection with orders and then order items as an array, then there is no need to have this again as part of order items. We can remove this element. So here we will make slight modifications to the script. As part of the projection after find, we will just discard underscore ID as well as order item order ID, and we'll only consider the rest of the fields, which are nothing but order item ID, product ID, quantity, subtotal, and product price. Also, even though order item ID is unique, going forward when we place orders, we might not enforce the uniqueness on order item ID. We will just give a incremented number within given order. So within a given order, if there are four order items, each order item will get number from 1 to 4. If another order have 3 items, then there will be only the range of numbers between 1 to 3. There is no need to enforce the uniqueness globally. So that being said, I can leverage this code with slight modifications. When it comes to the database name, it has to be retail stage because we have orders and order items in retail stage. Also, I need to have another object by name, something like orders final, which is pointing to retail orders. As part of the logic, I just have to have the projection where I'll be disabling ID as well as order item order ID. So let me copy paste this line of code and then say const retail stage equal to mongo connection.getDB retail stage. Also, we need to have retail and then const orders equal to retail stage orders. Const order items equal to retail stage order items and then order details, which is nothing but retail.orders. So our final table is also orders but in retail database. Now from here to here there are no changes, we just have to copy paste like this. So we are trying to fetch the data from orders and then we are trying to add order item details. However, after this, I have to have the projection logic here and I can say ID 0 and also order item order ID 0. Rest of the stuff we can leave as is. And then we can say for each order item details, order item details dot push order item, which will build the collection for us. And then if order item details dot length is not equal to 0, then I would like to insert the data with name order underscore items, not order underscore item details, just order underscore items equal to order item details, and then I can say retail dot order details dot insert one order details. Retail dot order details is nothing but, okay, in this case I shouldn't say retail dot order details. If I say retail dot order details, it will try to create a new collection by name order details. Already I have created a variable called as order details, which is pointing to retail dot orders, and hence I have to remove this retail here and then hit enter, close the curly brace for the arrow function and then circular brace for the for each and hit enter. Okay, the problem here is the variable name, this one and this one are same and hence it is failing. It is not inserting any data here. I have to change the name here. So I will just copy paste this one and then copy paste from here to here. And then I will say retail.orders.insert1 order details and then close this brackets and hit enter. Now the data is being inserted. You can see that the program completed successfully. Now we can say db.orders.count and we can see that there are 68,883 documents with respect to orders. We can preview the data by saying db.orders.findPretty. I think this orders is from retail stage. Let's switch to retail. Then say show collections and you can see this orders here. Now we can say db.orders.findPretty and hit enter. When it comes to order ID 19, there are two order items associated with it. Both of them are represented as list for the field order items on top of order ID, order date, order customer ID and order status for 19. Also, when you actually look into this list of order item documents, there is no order item order ID because we have discarded it as it is redundant information. When it comes to order item ID, at this time order item ID is unique. However, going forward, we will not enforce uniqueness at order item ID level. Within a given order, if there are 4 order items, we will just start with 1 and increment till 4. If we have 5 items, we will start with 1 and increment till 5 based on the order in which the items are added into the cart while placing our order. As we have understood some basics of data modeling and also created the necessary collections, now let us go ahead and start implementing the functionality to sign up the customers and then place the order, and then we'll also look into the dashboard. When it comes to placing the order, in this case, as orders and order items are consolidated into one collection, each and every order is one document into this orders collection. That orders will have multiple list of order items as one field, and hence even though we are actually having orders along with order items details with respect to a given order, as we are actually building one big document and inserting into a database as one atomic operation, our transaction management will become quite easier. Otherwise it will be a bit cumbersome if we have to deal with normalized data models when it comes to dealing with transactions such as orders where we have an order and also order items associated with it. That being said, when it comes to placing the order from the front end, we might get the details such as order ID, order date, order customer ID, order status. And with respect to order items, we might get the ID, which is nothing but the position of the item within the order, product ID, quantity, and product price. Order item subtotal is kind of derived field from quantity and product price, and hence from the front end we might not get this. We might want to compute while storing into the database. So we'll take care of that, and also we might have to perform the validations whether the product ID is valid or not. For that we need to look up into the product's dataset for this product ID for each order item, and if it is valid then only we should place the order. If it is not valid, we have to throw the exception. We'll get into those details as well as we start working on the necessary logic to place the orders in our application.